What is good, friends? And we are back with the deciding game for OUPL Finals. TDK was Gypsy King. If TDK wins, the Quebec Kratos Menace win OUPL. If Gypsy King wins, it's 4-4. We'll probably see more games. My lord. Okay, so TDK gets up the rocks. And this Latios is probably going to be Scarf Healing Wish. And then Avi Majerna, Zimuth probably on land or on Coco. He goes hard Coco on a heavy slam, that is so much. So I assume we're gonna see if this is Trinkle Tackle Tapu Coco, he could go for that, bringing the Zygarde. Or if it's in Power Eyes. Other than that, I assume he's just gonna U-turn. If he doesn't have the other moves, is what I meant. Yeah, let me drink something real quick. It wasn't Jirachi, which makes me think that it's Spadef Jirachi. Oh, never mind, that did 5 million. That is definitely offensive. He did predict HP Ice or the fairy move there. It's looking super good for TDK. He has the rocks up, he has the momentum. I mean, he can bring this Greninja in basically here. This Jirachi is offensive. I don't know if it's a Scarf Jirachi. At first glance, I would say it was Scarf Latios on Gypsy's King. But yeah, goes Greninja, and I know that TDK is a fan of, I think he's a fan of Ash Greninja, or he says it's very scary if you get off the form, but I mean that's true. I don't know if he said if you get off the form, but he's protein Greninja, which makes me think that it's Choice Scarf. Not that he's protein, the fact that he's U-turn makes me think that he's Choice Scarf. You don't really see U-turn on protein otherwise, like I haven't seen it at all. So that makes me think that the Latios is probably Soldu or Z-move. Because it makes a lot more sense now that I think about it. That the Greninja is probably Scarf Rock Slide. Because he is pretty weak to Volcarona otherwise. I mean, most Volcaronas don't run Bug Burst, so Latios can still check them. But I mean, if Latios gets prior chip damage on it, Volcarona can just pick that off, and like Latios can't really do that much back to Volcarona unless it's like Scarf T-Wave. Like, with Equivalence up, Draco's gonna do laughable damage, and it's a Scarf Latios, it's just a Latios. Like, it's not a Latios, it's a Latias. It's not that strong, especially if you don't have a boosting item. But yeah, this tournament is probably over, and the Andy's team, I will find out for you guys. I think the tech manager is Poik, but I'm really not sure. I don't want to say anything wrong. They're playing versus Mini Burgs and Obi's team, and it has been OUPL has been fun. It's a short tournament, and I shouldn't say it's over too early, but it's looking like TDK has this pretty much locked up. Like, he's playing well. Like, he has the early momentum on his side, is what I'm trying to say. Gypsy also has to defog for his Zard. And he decides to bring the Celesteela on the Tapu Koko, which is weird. Maybe this is Choice Tapu Koko? And he's gonna try to go Zygarde here. Okay, so he knows it's Choice. Oh, he assumes it's Choice the way he played that. Okay. So that worked. Let me see the leftover Zygarde. Okay, so it's probably Coil, or it could be Double Dance, but Double Dance is like Dragon Dance and Coil, which is most of the time with Citrus Berry. Leftovers is more so on Sub Coil. I mean, Coil Zygarde can be a threat, definitely, but Mamoswine plus Greninja. I assume he's gonna have Ice Beam on Greninja. Icicle Crash obviously on Mamoswine, they both checked that. The Mamoswine could be the Life Orb or Sash. It could be Z Move Mamoswine, that would be cool. But he gets an Latios. Not sure if he predicted the Mamo or the Lando. Maybe he predicted the Lando, because most Landers carry HP Ice to check Zygarde, so I can get behind that. It is Z-move Latios, and if it's not Focus Sash, it's gonna get blown away, so there goes the Mamoswine. I think this is HP Fire, these Psychic Z-move, this set is so cool. But yeah, the way he has been playing this Tapu Koko, it's either Specs or Scarf, I'm not really sure. I said the Greninja is probably Scarf. I think this is Specs Tapu Koko. Like, the Volt Switch did so much to Jirachi earlier, like, what the fuck was that? Yeah, I think it's Specs Tapu Koko, and you can click Dazzling Gleamy if he predicts the Lati to stay in, or if he predicts the predicts Gypsy to go Steela on a Fairy move, he can go for Volt Switch or T-Bolt. I don't think that TDK will give this match away. Man, I was really hoping the Gypsy could beat him. Like, on one hand, I'm completely fine with this tour being over, because I want to focus on recording World Cup games, but on the other hand, like, Teal kinda got hexed last game, if you didn't see it yet. And that, he's like, Matty Rolex team and Obi's team, they brought such cool teams. I really want to see them win this tournament, so I'm kinda sad if they will lose this game and they can't win, but they made it to finals, so it's, they did well, right? Only two teams out of six made it to finals. Yeah, World Cup is gonna be hype, because it's my first time that I will follow all these games, just with just like with FPL. And he does just play safe TDK, and he didn't really have a reason to overpredict, because he was in a good position there. Like, even if he went Celesteela, he could have still gone into like Majora and try to pivot around something like that. We're gonna see Leech Seed, I assume. Oh, Heavy Slam, okay. Why is that doing so much? Is that an offensive Celesteela? Or maybe the Landris is just offensive rocks, and because we don't see Rocky helmets, yeah. So this could be, oh, it's offensive explosion, cool. So maybe it's Focus Sash Lando. I can see the Magina going for Shifky here, because he's gonna predict the Protect and go for Shifky. Like, I wouldn't go for Protect here, but it's kind of the reason why he would gonna go for Protect is because the Giga Volt Havoc Z-move could come out here. I mean, I was thinking at first this is a Z-move, but TDK's team is looking kind of so it's looking so offensive that I'm not sure anymore. Like, and I don't know what else would be the Z-move user. If it's not the Lati, it has to be the Majora, I think. Or we don't know, it could have been the Mamoswine. Yeah, that's true. But like, more and more that we see what TDK's team does, I just think this is the Z-move user. And I honestly don't see what TDK, what Gypsy can do versus this. If it's the correct Majora set, it should just win the game from here. Like, Bolt Beam coverage pretty much killed Celesteela, Zygarde, and Charizard. I mean, if it's ZX, he can live a T-Bolt, but the third move is probably gonna be like, depends on the third move. The third move is Flash Cannon, Zard can potentially take a hit. And he did just Shifty on the Protect, as expected. Like, I assume I was pretty confident that he would go for Shift Gear there. But yeah, Gypsy did predict the move, or just wanted to get some lefties. He's gonna suck off his Clefable. It's Calm Mind, it's this set. In some scenarios, the set is not that good because it's lacking stab. But yeah, this game is over. So it's either Bolt Beam. Maybe it's just a T-Bolt and Flash Cannon. Oh, it doesn't have Flash Cannon, that did nothing. Never mind. Okay, this game is not over yet. I thought it had. Okay. I thought he would go for Z-move there and blow this Clefable away. Oh, maybe he didn't waste the Z-move yet. Erase Scarf, is this where we run Z-move Magina? I mean, maybe he wanted to save the Z-move, but... I guess they could have all caught. Hey, Ricardo, Gypsy better not talk to me again because he was using T-Wave. Yeah, but... if the Clefable can't touch the Magina... so this is either Rocks Clef or Calm Mind. I haven't seen the T-Wave Common Clef ever in Sun Moon. It would be cool if he's the first guy to bring it, and if it can pull out the victory for him, that would be so cool. Because Common Clefable can actually win here, that's crazy. With the Magina being paralyzed, so never speak too soon, this is Pokemon. But I think he's not Calm Mind, that's a bit sad. And yeah, that's the full para. That's just how para works. I assume it's gonna be Soft-boiled and then either Rocks and Moonblast. I mean, Moonblast is guaranteed on the Clef, but the last slot is between our Rocks and Flamethrower and Knockoff. Fucking ban this shit. Okay, he didn't say it like that. He said it a bit different. You guys can read it here. But yeah, so Steve is gonna go for... I don't really know what he braked it there. Because this showed a T-Build already, so I don't think he would want to stay in with Celesteela. Man, if he had Calm Mind there, Clefable would have been gold. Could have just gone for a game. The only way that TDK had to kill it was like, if his Latias, like, oh, he predicted him to pivot and he freezes and he saw that immediately. He predicted him to pivot in the Zygarde on a T-Bolt. Thankfully, he saw that immediately. So now he gets the seeds on the Magirna. I can see Gypsy going for Heavy Slam here. Just wanting to get some damage, but he just goes for Protect. Yes, he's paralyzed there. So that, like, even if TTK commented there, breaking the Protect, like, it didn't really matter. But yeah, probably would have just gone for Heavy Slam there. Either breaking TTK to get paralyzed or breaking him to go for Calm Mind. But yeah, now he can try to go Zygarde, exactly, or he can also hope for a para. As yeah, he does get the Zagat in. And now we can go for Substitute, so this game is not over yet. Like, at first I saw TDK as this for sure. But you know, T-Wave is a good move, right? Probably, I might have mentioned this already. But like, T-Wave can win. In RS, T-Wave was busted. Now it's a bit nerfed, it's 90% accuracy, and the speed drop is a bit... it got nerfed in that sense that... like, the monster only get the speed halved, not quartered, if that's the correct term. I don't really know how to say it in English, I know how to say it in German only. But yeah, he can fish sub and fish for para, so TTK might have to hard switch here because he can't really allow this to get up a free sub. Hard switch into what? Either Tapu Koko? Like, doesn't really matter. Any of the 3 months that he has left are able to break Zagat's substitute. It only matters in the sense that one of those 3 months might be more important. But he does go into Zard there, which is weird. What? Man, I thought he would just sub there. It's weird. I don't understand what this was. Like, I would have understand, like... oh, it's Zard X! Maybe this Greninja that only has Ice Beam and doesn't have Hydro Pump? So I assume he's gonna go for Roost. Or goes for Flabbit, damn. No, DDK looks like a god. And yet his Zard dies to Rocks and he doesn't have Hazard Control, so his Hazard Control is dead already, which was the Lati. So there's not really a point in saving this Zard. I mean, he can save it for fodder. The Lati is just gonna go for Psychic, I think? Psyshock? But he's gonna still steal it because he wants the sack for later. So yeah, I mean, that makes sense that he wants to keep it as a sack. I mean, I said he didn't really need it, but... an extra sack can come in clutch later on with Tapu Koko. Yeah. Psychic did absolutely nothing. Is this a free leech seed for Gypsy? Okay, goes for Heavy Slam. Not sure why he didn't leech seed. Yeah, there's a free protect to see what a Greninja does. It's low kick, okay, so maybe it's max attack then, yeah. Because Clefable predicting this Scarf, yeah, low kick is locked in. Scofable is still kind of threatening for GTK, not gonna lie. Man, I'm not sure anymore. Maybe it's double Scarf, because I don't think that's Spec Lottie, but Psychic only the 12% of Cell's dealer. I'm so confused. Is he Scarf Greninja plus Scarf Lottie? Like, the way the Grin has been played, it has to be Scarf to check, like, Zyga, look, Volcarona looking at the team and how it's been played, but, like, I'm not really sure anymore. Celestia can learn Iron Head. I don't know why they're looking that up. Does Iron Head have that Heavy Slam doesn't have? Give this you angry. Data. Does it have more PP or something? Yeah, Heavy Slam has 16 PP, so Iron Head has more PP. Most of the time, Heavy Slam should be stronger because Celestia weights. I think it weighs a lot. Let me actually check how much Celestia weighs. Oh, what the fuck, it almost weighs, it weighs like 1 ton, or however you say that, 999.9 kilogram. It's a fat mon. Good lord, yeah, the Heavy Slam is obviously better than, yeah. It doesn't even look that heavy. I mean, it looks heavy, but not that heavy. Actually, it kind of does, I don't know. Yeah, just ignore what I said. Gypsy's gonna double here, I assume. Let's just go for Moonblast, okay. I mean, that gets a drop there, but this, Majuna was paralyzed, it wasn't beating the Clefable. I would just Moonblast again here, in case TDK tries to, get something like the Gunshot Greninja in on a Soft-Boiled or on a, or on the Stealth Rocks. But TDK just has to go for Calm Mind, okay. Didn't think he would do that. This aura is Clefable winning with T-Wave. So he's Stealth Rock, Softball, Moonblast. And T-Wave, yeah. And Calm Mind would have been so clutch early on. But like I said, Gunkshot Grand Slayer would have been a problem. Yeah, so hard showing why it's broken, because if you sack a Pokemon, it still gets the boost. Understandable that Gypsy wanted to sack this out there and not go hard into Zygarde on an Ice Beam. If he has Sub, you can click that, and you can click 1000 Arrows if he doesn't have Sub. He does not kill a Greninja, damn. Zygarde is weak if you don't, like, if you don't run, if you're used to Bandit Zygarde, which does, like, good damage. It's kinda annoying how little damage it does sometimes. If he has Ice Beam here, he can click that, and he does have Ice Beam. And it does nothing, cause he's, he has U-turn and low kick, so I'm thinking he's, like, Max Attack Greninja, or definitely more physical based. And yeah, there's a free softball for Gypsy, and this Clefable is keeping him, keeping him in the game. But if TDK can basically go either for the freeze here or decide, okay, he can switch into Tapu Koko. So he has his choice specs Tapu Koko. At first I thought he would make that play in the Koko for sure, but then I realized I could Ninja Dice to Rock, so I wasn't sure anymore. But yeah, it's kinda... Like, if he goes for T-Bolt, Clefable will get blown away here. It will take like 80. I could see him going for Dazzling Gleam because the Zygarde is kind of obvious. But this turn might be the game deciding turn. My lord. I think he will just go for T-Bolt because this Clefable is really annoying. And if I'm TDK, I'm like, I'm not playing around with this Clef because this Clef needs to go. And if he's, like, just what I would think, if he was gonna allow me to kill the Clef, I will definitely take the chance. Like, I wouldn't want to overpredict here, but I'm lagging, man. Oh, yeah, he does overpredict. Gypsy catches him there. That game would have been over if he went Zyga, but he got that play correct. And he can go for Softball, and yeah, now he's pretty much free to click Moonblast again. So Gypsy actually working his way back into the game as he just sacks off the Greninja. That was pretty well done. I mean, he did get some nice paras earlier, but still, I thought this game was, like, in TDK's favor at the beginning, like, super, like, a lot, and I already spoke like it was over, but at that point I thought it was, Z-Move Majuna with, like, the perfect coverage that could just win the game, but and was lacking a move to hit the Clefable, or as he moved to blow this Clefable away. I think you can just click Moonblast again, because this Magearna is paralyzed, like... TDK can potentially Ice Beam, try to predict the Zygarde switch, that's an option. Because the Zygarde might be the play that Gypsy might wants to make, if he wants to predict the T-Bolt slash Calm Mind. Like, mainly Calm Mind is what I'm thinking here, but Calm Mind is kind of obvious. So there's some mind games going on here. I'll probably just stay and go for the Moonblast special attack drop because it's paralyzed, and I'm like, paralyzed bro, why not? I mean, that's definitely me, that what I would do on a ladder in a tournament game. Might make a different play. On the ladder, I just don't really care, and I'm like, this guy's paralyzed, like, you're not breaking through, get me out of here. Felt paralyzed broken for a reason, right? Maybe just decide to make the Zygarde play. Did he make the Ice Beam? If he makes the Ice Beam play, this guy's a god. He goes on the top of Coco, and if I'm Gypsy here, I'm going into Clefable here. I think he's just gonna Dazzling Gleam. I think he's just gonna Dazzling Gleam, yeah, for sure. Actually, if he's a Spadef Zygarde and he can lift the hit, he might want to stay in. Oh, also, if he has E-Speed, he can pick off the Tapu Koko. I was going off the last move being Toxic the entire time, but he could actually be E-Speed. That would be clutch for a Gypsy. So, yeah. If he's E-Speed, he can just click that, and if he's not E-Speed, we would have to Kulk. But his time is kind of low, so I don't want to Kulk and miss this deciding turn. But I kind of want to Kulk a Tapu Koko. Does it have a spec set? Yeah, the Kulk doesn't have a spec set. Let's just say Zygarde or you subcoil Tapu Koko. Let's give it a choice specs. HP Ice doesn't kill, and yeah, exactly, it's for death. Like I was about to say. HBS doesn't kill, so I'm pretty sure Dazzling Gleam also doesn't kill. It only has 68. Should have known that Spadef Zygarde is able to eat that up. And I think he can save this, because it's a 100 guaranteed way of killing the Magearna. Even though the Magearna should probably die to Heavy Slam after Rocks. So yeah, I'm pretty sure Gypsy wins this. Wow. Okay, I didn't say anything at the beginning. Shout out to Gypsy, well played. I mean, he had the correct sets, and that one turn where, I don't know if I want to say TDK choked, but that one, maybe it was a 50-50, that one turn where he went for Dazzling with Knuckle Fable, that was pretty much, that was a really big turn. If he T-bolted there, the Clefable would have still lived, and the Gypsy would have gone for Softball, the Clefable would have been a bit low. And I'm pretty sure that TDK would have doubled on the next turn predicting the Zygarde, so there would have been another 50-50, so it's kind of hard to say how they would have played that. There would have been another kind of mind game going on. I hope Gypsy doesn't time out, because his timeout is at 20 seconds. And I really want to see him pull this out. No, don't time out! Click a fucking move, dude! Oh, he clicked the move, phew. He decides to go into Clefable, the Healing Wish into Magearna is there, so Clefable is going to click Thunder Wave here, and if he hits, this game's over. And he does hit the Thunder Wave, and he should win now. Combination of Thousand Arrows plus Heavy Slam plus Moonblast should just win the game. Phew. Regardless of what a joke of a game. Yeah, I don't know. I spoke Gypsy King out early game because I just thought that Magearna had the correct coverage, but you live and you learn, and I know that I will make these mistakes again sometime, but I hope I can avoid them. At least he goes Hardness Zygarde, which is a bit risky, but he's just gonna go for Calm Mind. Like, it's understandable. He wasn't Ice Beaming there. But it was still kind of risky. And he's still faster. No! So this game is not over yet. This Magearna can still pull out the win. Okay, so he's gonna go for Leech Sheet or Heavy Slam. Oh my god, this Magearna still wins. I was just talking like Gypsy turned it around. Because I thought Zygarde outspeeds the Magearna, but I forgot about that para nerf and the EZ move, and he kept it for the entirety of the game. And TDK still wins, my lord. What the fuck, dude? What? Yeah, like, I didn't expect the Zygarde to get outsped there. Wow. I just thought that Gypsy had the game. I'm way too used to Gen 6 mechanic where Para like nerfs the speed way more. Even though I just mentioned earlier, I think that Para got nerfed in that sense. And they're saying Z-Move Mag won the game, dumbass. Did I win the game earlier too? Hey, Ricardo said, fuck you, Seb. But yeah, the Antis team just won OUPL. And congratulations. I really thought that Gypsy had it at the end there. I was just used to Para being broken. I thought the Midjourney would have gone Para there. But Solhot and Coleman just coming in clutch for Midjourney. I'm not sure how I feel about this set. I've seen it like 2 or 3 times used Shift Gear plus Calm Mind. Because I feel like you kind of lose out on coverage. I mean, Bolt Beam is still great coverage. But Focus Blast or Z All Out Pummeling is just really nice to have sometimes. Depends on the team, obviously. Maybe TTK's team was built around this specifically, because Specs Tapu Koko is really nice. It's one way to like just weaken Heatran. Heatran would be in check to this Magina set. Damn, that was close. Yeah, I'll pause it real quick and just make sure, which team, who is the second coach? Not coach. Manager, however you say it, of the Kevai Kratos Miner. So, see you guys in a bit. Okay, so the second manager was AvalCL. At one point I said Poig, I was wrong. Poig was managing the top zone Noctowls. They didn't make it to playoff. Okay. Yeah, okay. So, congrats to AvalCL and Kratos Miner. And TDK really, they only had 10 players. It's kind of interesting because if you look at the other teams, they have way more players. Like 18 players, 16, 17, they only have 10. But like TDK went for 41k, which is like crazy. Well, Pearl pulled off, like, I think he pulled a lot of wins for the team. I don't remember that many TDK games because mainly he was playing older gens and didn't really follow that. Ricardo, like, he was on a win streak at the beginning and I think he lost the last two games, but he was doing pretty well overall and definitely a help for the team. And yeah, I want to just check out the posts here. What do we see? Oh, it's probably supposed to be GOAT, greatest of all time. And I have 1GG 41k. We just like this post. What else do we have here? They're just spamming the same thing. But yeah, I'm glad that we can round it up. Even though I really want to see Gypsy win. Man, why is everyone posting this? Stop. Man, I was fearing that I have to wait for till tomorrow till this game. Which would be so annoying because there's like S2 and stuff going on. Sacrifice some sleep for you guys. Hope you enjoy it. I was able to get pretty much every game that I wanted to record, which was these five games. I think I've kind of fucked up the narration in this one. And yeah, my narration wasn't always the best, but it had, I think overall it's not that bad. And yeah, I just didn't record these because I'm not too much into all legends. Black and white is okay, but I'm fine with only recording the black and white games for our smoke tours, even though I should really learn the team more so my narration gets a bit better. I mean, Gypsy brought it down pretty close. T-Wave being a good move, but yeah, Healing Wish clutched it out for TDK. I just thought that it was over, like, even if he had Healing Wish, he just gets T-Waved again, and I thought he loses, like, what? T-Wave is broken, like, how did you break out all the time at the end? And yeah, I also thought that Zygarde would just bring this super low. Because I thought that Zygarde would outspeed it, but yeah, Shift Gear just cancelled out the speed drop because Para got nerfed. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. My man Easy's also on this team by on managed by FLCL and Kratos Mana, so grats to him too. And yeah, grats to all these guys, I guess. I mean, I don't know Ricardo well, but I know him a little bit. So yeah, thanks to you. What the fuck am I saying? Congrats to you, dude. Yeah, it's clearly not the time to be awake. I should be asleep. But this was definitely fun. Like, I don't regret staying up for this. And gonna be looking forward to bringing you guys more Smogtris series. We will have two more Smogtris series coming up for quarterfinals, and then yeah, we will move on to semifinals and finals. And World Cup is just around the corner, so that is pretty hyped. Padlop on Team Germany, probably. I think he's on a bench, but yeah, we'll see if he will get subbed in at one point. That's pretty much it. I don't really know if I forgot anything. Thank you guys for watching, and peace.